at this conference today, and I'm sure everyone is as deeply honored and privileged as I am to welcome our very, very high level and special set of speakers for this first session. May I start by inviting our session chair and moderator, Mr. Sanjeev Gupta, MD NextGen Financial Solutions, Mr. Gaurav Joshi, Senior Environmental Specialist, Environment and Natural Resources Global Practice from IBRD, IDA World Bank Group, Mr. Pinaki Bhattacharya, CEO, AMP Solar Group, Mr. Raghunath Mahapatra, Head Solar Business from Hero Future Energies, Mr. Pradeep Chauhan, Country Manager, India from SolarPack as an IPP from Spain, Mr. Lokane Singh, Head Business Development South, Mr. Oriano Solar. We'll also be joined by Mr. Gaurav Sood, who is the CEO of Spring Energy, Mr. Manu Srivastav, who is MD of MP Urja Vikas Nigam Limited, and they will join us as they are right now stuck in traffic. So in next 10-15 minutes, we'll be joined by them. Ladies and gentlemen, may I request everyone to welcome our speakers with a big round of applause. And especially, I'd like to welcome Mr. Sanjeev Agrawal, founder and CEO of Amplus Energy. So we are honored to have you, sir, today.
Consulting firm, asset management company for solar PV market. We are present in almost 12 countries now, and it's my pleasure to be sharing the dais with all the dignitaries here. Thank you.
Hello, good morning everybody. My name is Lokendra. I represent Oriano Clean Energy. We are into e-business of EPC of solar power projects.
Good morning, my name is Gaurav. I work at the International Bank for Reconstruction and Development. Most of you know of it as the World Bank. We are in the renewable energy space, mostly with government counterparts across solar. Now floating, I saw some very interesting clips as I was waiting to be held up to the dais. And I'll be very happy to see this interest and to provide information.
I'm Pinaki Bhattacharya. I'm the CEO of AMP in India. So AMP is a global IPP with operations in Canada, US, Japan, Australia, and now in India. And that's about it, actually. I can speak about further details about the company and what we do at a later introductory remark. Thank you.
Thank you. My name is Sanjeev Gupta. I run a merchant banking company called NextGen Financial Solutions Private Limited. We are focused on renewable energy and power sector and have been advising various state governments, private sector and other, including as a financial advisor to the Solar Mission of Gujarat, and help in raising funds and also in mergers and acquisition in renewable and power sector. So we'll keep sharing more about the things and the agendas as we go on. Thank you.
Hi, good morning. My name is Sanjeev Agarwal. I represent Amplus Solar. Amplus Solar is largely working in the C&I space in India and across Asia. Thank you.
Good morning. I am Raghunath Mahapatra. I represent Hero Future Energies. We are a solar and wind IPP, and we are also trying to get into the EV space through hybrids EV space.
So I think what we would do with this is that, as Pinaki rightly said, that maybe a little more of about the organization and what we think, how the renewable energy space is shaping up. Maybe we will start with some opening comments, a brief opening comments about how we believe the renewable energy space is shaping up and what it will take to be successful here. So what are the needs and what it will take from all of us to be successful, and how we feel that the governments should help us, if at all, and what the lenders and investors can do a little more, And maybe I'll specifically be requesting Sanjeev to also share one of the biggest success story today, which is about M+ and how they have built a company and what is his mantra to actually build an in a matter of not even a decade, I would say. So I'll be requesting him. So I'll start again from you, and if you can make some opening comments, please.
Thank you, Mr. Gupta. So I have a couple of points which I would like to specifically mention how we feel about working here in India. We are a European company, and what are the challenges any one of us should be facing, or what are specific challenges we are facing, and how should we go about it working towards achieving common goal of for the nation to accomplish a very tedious task of 175 gigawatt of renewable energy, specifically 100 gigawatt of solar. So coming back to the first point, how we feel about it, we Spanish company specialize into solar PV development, EPC, and all other aspect, including consulting, asset management, design engineering. So we ventured here in India in 2015 late, and we participated in some of the state programs, central programs, for acquiring some of the projects under competitive bidding. And 2016, we have got some success by winning 100 megawatt in Telangana. Primarily, we wherever we establish projects in our own investment capacity globally, we do our own in-house EPC elsewhere. So first challenge for us was to convince lenders, convince other stakeholders. For a newcomer, is it possible to execute projects here in India? So that was the first challenge. And here in India, lenders generally accept the proposals wherein the EPC company or the developer must have, you know, demonstrated certain number of megawatts, track records have been developed here in India, irrespective of whatever you have done globally. So adaptability to the experiences you have gained outside is, it's not very very much taken as it is by various stakeholders, whatever are your credentials outside globally. So that was the first challenge we faced. So after doing first set of project, now this year we are building about another set of 100 megawatt, 130 megawatt in Karnataka. And now things are more acceptable to other partners. I don't know what is this theory of must have.
We are taking the technology from this globally demonstrating technology in various aspects. This specific requirement of working here in India is, we feel it is something which is holding back adapting to the new technology or opening arms to the partners or the participants from different geographies to come here and contribute to the overall mission success. That's what. Then now we are very much confident about this market. In fact, solar is going to be one of the largest market. We operate in European countries, which is now again coming back to the momentum. We are very well present in Latin American market, Chile, Peru, Uruguay for almost a decade. Advantage to us is Latin America is mostly Spanish speaking countries. So that is one of the largest market here for us. But now India is the main focus for the growth. Not many of the small developers or mid-sized developers similar to us have been working here for 3 years, having developing projects every year almost. So we have pivoted our success and confidence in the market, and we are looking for a very long time presence here, if not opportunistic as such. Another dimension which we are now working is there are other players here and they are very successful in the CNM market. And I see very huge potential in the CNM market when we provide energy solutions to the large customers who are mainly dependent on the utility sectors or the utility, where the cost of energy is something which goes as input cost to the raw materials or to the current product. So the large customers or the industry wants to balance out their energy portfolio. We will be working in that segment in coming days or coming years now, apart from the utility scale or from the current PPAs. Going forward, what we see good change which is going to come in the market is moving towards floating solar, solar with storage, wind solar hybrid with storage, and these are the things which are we feel it's going to come very quickly, even though we might not have foreseen those changes will come so quickly couple of years back, but despite couple of setback in last year with respect to safeguard duty, some cancellations of auction and other. So India has auctioned a couple of 100 megawatts in floating solar, which is a good thing, although the movement has been slow. And then solar hybrid and storage is also one thing which has happened. Large auctions happen, which are, I think, important, very important development at the starting point.
Pradeep, can I request you to be brief, because we thought we'll give 1 to 2 minutes each, so that we rapidly go through this and then take the.
So I think these are details. Few things which makes us very, very hopeful in this market. And momentum will take place, which will keep on going irrespective of whatever the setbacks happens in between. Thank you very much.
So Lokendra, I request that with as opening comments, can you briefly bring out your key observations that you have till now, and how you see the sector shaping up with your contribution? So, and what you need, maybe.
What I see is this market is continuing to grow, and I think just day before yesterday, our Honorable Vice President has also made a remark that India will go to install somewhere around 237 gigawatt of renewable capacity by 2022. So that means they are quite clear that renewable space is continuing to grow. Now how it's going to shape up, whether it's going to shape up through solar power, C&I market, or a small segment like which is less than 100 megawatt of space, that really need to be seen. When we talk about C&I market space, it is also dependent on the individual states' policies, where usually there is a lot of uncertainties on the regulations part. And currently, we really don't know which state is coming up and suddenly it goes down. Maharashtra still is not going good. Tamil Nadu, there are certain challenges. So every state is coming up, but it is adding lot many challenges and uncertainties, which needs to be seen. What I can say is, yes, storage plus hybrid. Hybrid is something which is almost under the verge, like wind plus solar. It may come as soon as the regulations comes up, but this is something which needs to be done and is going to come up. Thank you.
From our perspective, since we work mostly with the government, two things stand out. as Mr. Singh said, we're most likely to see the continued thrust on renewables as World Bank, we stand ready to help the government. We are in partnership with organizations like IREDA, SBI, and even SECI. So technology-wise, I think we are on a path where items which are currently not on the horizon as viable will be experimented with. So we mentioned about floating solar. We hope that that will pick up, because in India, from a policy perspective, if you see, land remains a constraint. What we think is land not in use, maybe there's a gaucher somewhere, there is somebody else's claim. So that is at our density levels, that is something that we will continue to explore. How can we innovate? And with the government of India's advice or insistence, I should say, we are already partnering with them for looking at innovative technologies. So that is going up. Globally, I think the World Bank is already looking to help storage, and we put money where our mouth is. Actually, $1 billion have been committed by our senior management to developing storage solutions. So I think that the renewable energy space is going to be a very exciting and a growing space. Issues that may come up will include probably prioritizing one technology over the other in some ways, but also looking at issues of how do we manage the environmental impacts. I think the government of India has just started looking at anti-money containing panels, but this will expand. So that is something that I see emerging as the market develops, as we grow beyond a certain point. And it is all for the good, because if we want to do 237 gigawatts, then we'd better be ready to do this at scale. Thank you.